If I hadn't had those dumb deaths earlier. No, you know what? Fuck it, I'm playing again. I'm gonna do this shit. And then I'm gonna get into, restarting over and over on stage one, as always happens. Okay, I completely fucked that up. Oh no. Did the wrong gun tanks in space get the... get the gifts up? Well, that's not good. Damn, that's pretty fucked up. Yeah, I'm sorry. I don't know what I can do about it. I guess lesson learned, to be extra careful when gifting a sub to someone? Oh. Twitch is apparently really fucked up tonight. Hopefully it doesn't cause too many problems. It seems like these things happen a lot on Thursdays. Like, this isn't the first Thursday where they did some stupid update right before I wanted to stream. Once I got it loaded, everything seems fine. Like, there were problems with, like, Franker faces earlier, apparently. Well, thank you again, Iron Sheik. Good lord, all this generosity. You're a good guy, Iron Sheik. Tempting to try to destroy as many missiles as possible just to increase or decrease the kill counter at the bottom, but I think that could get me into trouble here. Since you have to decrease the counter to zero to get the sub boss thing to show up and get the medals, and you gotta be at max rank for the 500,000 bonus on wave 6 or wave 5. Is it wave 5? Yeah, wave 5. I don't think you can disable the quote-unquote continue cutoff. It's not an actual hard cutoff. What happens is if you're still given the option to continue, but it sends you back to wave 7. It doesn't disable continues entirely like in Rygar or Time Soldiers or Shinobi or any of those. Kind of some weird phrasing on that, but I don't know if there's an option to disable that entirely. In a way, it's like not to, well, I take that back. Wave 8 sucks, but when you start over, your score starts from 0, so you can actually earn a few extra lives again, since extras are at 50,000, 200,000, and 500,000. The downside is you got to go through wave 8 again, so. Yeah, Rastan also cuts off continues on the last stage. And of course, the last boss in M1975. Who can forget that? Screen level. Little ship carrier. Yeah, I don't know why they left it in hexadecimal. That had to cause a lot of confusion. Especially in the late 80s. I mean, not as many people like knew it. What hexadecimal even was. Which I imagine a lot of players didn't even understand what the number was used for anyway. Oh yeah, there is a prototype version of this that's like supported in MAME now. I don't remember all the differences, but it did seem a little bit easier, but one of the noteworthy changes is that I think they got rid of the Poseidon bonus entirely. So you couldn't get the 500,000 bonus at all. It's kind of a bummer. It's pretty satisfying. Whoa, why did that take so long? That's some good place to get bonuses. I don't know, one of the things I find interesting about this game is just they throw so many items at you to give you invulnerability. And it's what you end up having to do is like you want to like chain them together in such in the right way, because like if you pick up a sparkly when the sparklies are already going around you, then it automatically blows everything up. But when the sparklies stop, there's like 2 seconds where your jeep starts flashing like that, and during that period you can actually pick up that sparkly again to re-sparkly, I guess you could call it, keep the invulnerability going. Also, the bonus items that the sub bosses drop, those give you the 2 second period of invulnerability, which will overwrite the sparklies entirely. So it's like you don't want to overwrite the sparklies with the normal invulnerability period. There's kind of some strategy to it. And, you know, it feels good to just be invulnerable for a shitload of time. Yeah, once you're at max rank, if you die, you automatically have the auto fire and the twin shot. Damn it. But I don't know why this stage just tosses out so many of the sparklies at you, like, the entire stage. Not that I'm complaining, mind you, it's just a little weird. Okay, wave 8, let's do this shit. Let's not die at the beginning this time. That part sucks. I couldn't get the right angle. Oh, come on! I thought the missiles were done. Two deaths! It's always two deaths on stage 8. Sorry about these noises. Oops. Oh no. Shit. Give me that. Whew. Yeah, I'm getting into it a little too much, but that's a nice thing to see, right? Nice thing to see somebody enjoying it. It just sounds awful when taken out of context. But that, I should be used to that already. Things that happen in the stream. Weird formations in Star Force when you get to, like, when you get past Cleopatra. The enemy formations get all weird for a while. I don't think anybody knows what I'm talking about right now, but... Somebody toss me a sparklet. Thank you. Okay. 3 lives in reserve for the final wave. The quote-unquote final wave. I forgot what to do at the end, so this will be interesting. I think my score is lower than last time, though, unfortunately. Didn't kill as much stuff. Dr. Madnar, thank you very much for the brand new sub. Much appreciated. You will, of course, be eligible for the arcade sub raffle action going on after this game. Holy shit, that's a lot of stuff. That was a mistake. I knew it. Again. Yes! So that was supposed to be the final stage, but then what happens after this, you just go to wave 12, which is an infinite stage, it never ends. So this stage is like a victory lap, I guess. And they add that weird circular thing that was firing missiles, that thing. Can't destroy it though, except with the sparklies. So I guess it's a 1cc, but it's not, it doesn't actually end, so. Which is too bad, because imagine how much higher the bonus could get if you could keep playing more stages. Once again, I should have been recording this for Mark, but I didn't. Let's see how much longer I can take this last life. I'm not sure if this has been counter-stopped. It might have been. There might have been some insane Japanese player that played this long enough. Alright, pretty happy with that.